Oletala ne, male Pasifika. Here's your Pacific news. Two Tivaevae held by a London hotel for an unpaid bill by a group of Cook Islands women will be returned to New Zealand. The Tivaevae were among artworks held following a trip to England and France in April to honour Cook Islands World War I soldiers. But a hotel spokesman says the Tivaevae will be returned as they were not held as payment. However, four glass sculptures by artist and tour organiser Nia Valtali will be sold to pay the hotel bill.
We're not keeping them as payment, and we're not intending for them to be sold in order to pay that bill. Nia Val has instructed a friend of hers to sell her four glass sculptures, and the money that she raises through the sale of those sculptures will be used to pay the outstanding bill.
Tully has come under fire since the women returned from the trip over a month ago. The unpaid bill, they say, is just one in a long list of grievances. Prime Minister Bill English is hoping his visit to Samoa will give him an edge in September's election after a traditional Salfa'i ceremony in Samoa. English was made a matai in his wife's village of Faleula, where he was given the title of Leulua'ialiiotumua. It's the first time English has visited Samoa as PM and says the matai title is less about politics and more about relationships.
This is about the long-standing links between New Zealand and Samoa, but also the fact thousands of families in New Zealand and Samoa are connected by relationship. People make up their own mind about the politics. This is a real honour to be able to come here.
English returns to New Zealand today before heading to the Cook Islands, Tonga and Niue later in the month. And still with the Pacific, regional leaders have expressed disbelief at President Donald Trump's decision to pull the US out of the Paris Agreement on climate change yesterday. Tuvalu President Enele Sopoaga has ordered his officials to stop cooperating with the US, while Fiji Prime Minister Frank Bainimarama said it was deeply disappointing for vulnerable nations. Promising Pasifika businesses are exploring the digital frontier thanks to Te Papa's Mahuki Innovation Hub and the Pacific Business Trust. Six businesses ranging from design, social media, language protection and technology took part in a three-day workshop looking at opportunities in the global culture and heritage sector.
Having the Pacific teams come in, not only do they bring incredible business skills with them, but they also bring a really fresh perspective. So we think there's lots of opportunities for them.
Being here, you know, it's more of an opportunity where we can actually learn, experience, and also to understand, the processes of what Te Papa is going to offer.
The workshop included a dragon's den, and teams will have the opportunity to apply for the Hub's accelerator program. And finally, Aradhana and Kings were the big winners at the Vodafone Pacific Music Awards on Thursday night. Aradhana picked up four awards, including Best Pacific Female Artist, as well as the TUI for the coveted Best Pacific Music Album. Kings also collected four awards, including Best Pacific Urban Artist and one dear to his heart, Best Producer. The People's Choice Award went to reggae band Three Houses Down, featuring 11-year-old General Fire. They also took the award for Best Pacific Group. To round out the night, veteran Cook Islands artist Brother Love received the Lifetime Achievement Award. And Tangata Pasifika will bring you a special highlight show of the awards next week.